Today we're paddling along the Little Beaver Kill, which is a very appropriately named stream, because we're finding all kinds of evidence of a common watershed aquatic critter, the American beaver. Shows how amazingly adapted the beaver is to life in the water. They have a really thick fur, and they have a special gland that secretes oil onto their fur, which basically makes it waterproof. So when these guys get out of the water, all they have to do is shake off, and all that water runs right off, and they're pretty much dry, which is a really useful thing to have, because these guys don't hibernate. They stay active all year long. When the pond freezes, only the top of the pond is ice. There's actually water below the pond, and the beaver will go outside under his opening in the lodge and swim around to get sticks that he's put on the bottom for food for his winter cache. And so having waterproof fur is a really helpful thing. Typical beaver will get somewhere around 3 feet long and can weigh anywhere from 40 to 60 pounds, which is quite large, probably about the size of a medium dog. They're not very agile on the land. They're pretty clumsy on the land. They're more perfectly suited for life in the water. Here's the skull of a beaver. The beaver is actually the largest rodent in North America. And you can always tell rodents by these big orange teeth. These are called incisors. All rodents have teeth like that. And these incisor teeth are constantly growing, which is really good for a beaver because they need good sharp teeth for chewing all those trees down. When we look at the other teeth of the beaver, we notice they're all flat. And that kind of gives us a clue as to what kind of eater they are. Beavers are herbivores. They eat only plant material. So lots of flat teeth for chewing up bark and leaves and twigs and buds. As these teeth continue to grow, they stay razor sharp, which is why a beaver can chew through huge tree trunk. So they have really powerful jaw muscles, which allow them to get a really good bite when they're gnawing on trees and sticks. As we noticed earlier, we saw lots of evidence along the beaver kill of what I call beaver chews, which is basically where beavers have chewed on a tree to knock it down. Remember, they're interested in the branches up in the top of the tree, but they can't climb, so the only way to get to those branches is to chew the tree down. So imagine this being a medium sapling, and a beaver coming over and gnawing on that and working his way through. And then what they usually do is go around the other side until they get to a point. And when it gets to a point at some point, gravity is going to take a hold of the tree, and timber, down comes the tree. And then the beaver will chew on the tree, get the branches that it wants, and it'll gnaw. It'll gnaw at all the bark, because it loves to eat that bark. You can see the chew marks right on the stick here where it's been chewed. Once they're done eating all the parts that they want off of the tree, they'll then use this as a building material for their lodges, for their dams. Nothing goes to waste. As I mentioned before, beavers are perfectly adapted for life in the water. Here is a beaver tail. And the tail would attach, obviously, to the back of the beaver. Kind of like this. Right. And this tail is an amazing tool for the beaver. It acts as a paddle to help them swim. When they're in the water, they use it more like a rudder, which helps them steer. They also use it to defend themselves. They typically don't have a lot of things bothering them in the water, but if you were to get close to a beaver, it would warn you to stay away by slapping its tail on the water and splashing water toward you and making a really loud slapping noise. And that's the way it warns other animals that you're in my territory, stay away. When we look at the beaver's footprints, we get a sense of what their paws are like. The front paws are very hand-like and typical for a mammal. You can see the long claws on there, different fingers. Their front paws are quite agile. They can grab sticks, they can hold things, and so that's what that looks like. But when we look at their back paws, we see something quite different. Their back paws are much larger, and notice they have webbing between their toes, which is another adaptation they use for swimming in the water. I don't know if you've ever worn swim fins before, if you've been in a pool, but if you have webbed fins, you can swim a lot better than if you didn't. And so this is a great way for them to move through the water swiftly and quickly along with that tail. We're sitting on top of this beaver dam. Beavers really are nature's engineers. When we look at this thing, it's amazing. It's several hundred feet long, and from down on the water surface, it's probably 5 to 6, maybe even 7 feet high. And when we look closely, we see it's built of mud and all kinds of sticks. When we look at the sticks carefully, we see that they've been chewed. All the bark is missing. And you can see where the beaver chewed the stick off of the tree and then placed it here with mud and rocks and all this material to create a pond. If you look over here, we can see how the stream has been ponded up to create this amazing aquatic environment. Over in the middle there, we can see a beaver lodge. That's the home of the beaver, right there in the middle. So here in the middle of the pond that the beavers created is their house, known as a beaver lodge. A lodge is basically a giant dome of sticks and mud that extends quite a few feet below the surface of the water. The walls of the lodge are very thick. They provide good insulation even in the cold winter, but more importantly, they provide protection for the beaver. There's no door or window on the outside of this lodge. The entrance to the lodge is below the water, and that's intentional so that no predators can get at the beaver. So when they want to get in the lodge, they swim over and find the underwater entrance, and they swim up in, and then inside of this lodge, it's actually hollow, and there are several chambers that have platforms, like little islands that stick out of the water that are dry, and that's where the beaver hangs out. It's where they sleep, where they eat, where they take care of their young. They actually have several entrances around this lodge so that if they were to have something try to get at them, they could have multiple ways of getting in and out, kind of like we have a front door and a back door to our house. Like the dam, the beaver lodge is an amazing feat of engineering. The dam and the lodge are set up so that the water level stays at a constant level so as not to flood their chambers or their rooms. We look closely, we see it's made up of all of these chewed sticks. They all have beaver chews on the end of them, where they got gnawed off from the trees. They've all been stripped of their bark for the most part, which is the food, and then recycled or reused to make their home. Beavers are pretty amazing critters. So we found several beaver lodges along this stretch of the Little Beaver Kill today, which is an indication that we have a really healthy and active population of beavers. Typically, when young beavers are about 2 years old, as their parents are having a new litter of kits, the two-year-olds will have to leave the lodge and go out on their own. And so we're seeing lots of beaver lodges, most likely from the offspring of the parent beavers upstream. So here we see another example of a beaver lodge. This one's called a bank lodge. It's actually built along the bank of the stream in the middle of this thicket of this bush. This beaver used a lot of mud and sticks and weaved it all around the trunks of this bush to create a bank lodge. There's probably at least two or three openings along the front of this lodge to get in and out of it into the stream. So we have the classic dome lodge out in the middle of a pond or a river, and we have this style, the bank lodge, along the edge of the stream. So beavers are herbivores, which means they only eat plants. In fact, what they really like to eat are the tops of trees. They love the branches, the twigs, the buds, the leaves. Those are the things they really want to eat, and that's why they chew the trees down, to get to the tops. Their absolute staple food is the bark of twigs. And so they'll take a branch like this and just chew off all of that bark and eat it. And what you end up with is a stick that looks like this, completely free of all its bark. Almost like you or I would eat corn on the cob. Mm-hmm. Look closely, we can see the chew marks from the beaver on here. Now, come summertime, they also like to eat aquatic vegetation. Things like lily pads and cattails, which are kind of like those hot dogs on a stick. They love to eat those kinds of things. So as we explore the area around the beaver dam, we notice lots of beaver activity. Look here. Here's a tree that was chewed last year. Right? You can see all the teeth marks on there where the beaver worked for a better part of a couple hours and then knocked that tree over. There's another one over here. And another. And another. Several more back there. So here we see where the beaver was chewing on this tree, and he got almost all the way through it and it fell over, but it got hung up in the other trees. So he wasn't able to use it. So that's why he didn't chew all the way through it. As we look around here, there's so much beaver evidence. I come over here, there's a really large pine tree over here. And look, he's been chewing all on here. There's all kinds of chew marks. He's just getting started. They'll keep working on this tree. And eventually they'll get this tree to knock over. It's amazing the size of the trees that they can chew through. So beavers are perfectly adapted for life in the water. However, when they get out on the land, they're pretty clumsy and very vulnerable to becoming prey. Things like coyotes, foxes, bobcats will prey on beavers, and they can get them when they're on the land. However, they have no natural enemies in the water. There's nothing that bothers them in the water. And so what they tend to do when they've built their pond and they've used all of the food around the pond, they'll want to go deeper in the forest to get new sticks and new trees. And so what they do is they actually create these things called beaver canals, which are little canals that go back into the woods. This wasn't here. The beaver came in here and actually pushed out all the mud from off the bottom and the sediment, chewed away the branches and made himself a waterway where he can come and go into the woods and get more food. The other thing that the canal does for him, instead of having to drag a big tree branch over the land, he can easily float it out of the woods along this canal back to the lodge. So here we see a pretty good section of a beaver canal. The beaver completely dug this out to make it so he could travel and carry chewed trees through here. So here we see another one of the beaver canals heading off far into the wood line. So the beaver is what we call a keystone species. Like people, beavers are able to create their own environment, their own habitat. By making that dam over there, the beaver created this pond you see all around us. And in doing so, they created this amazing aquatic environment, wetland atmosphere, that provides homes for all sorts of species. Birds, reptiles, amphibians, all sorts of animals will move in to this new habitat, all thanks to the beaver. I want to talk about some other really amazing adaptations that the beaver has, especially those that are designed for life in the water. When a beaver goes underwater, they can hold their breath for up to 15 minutes without having to surface for air, which is pretty cool. Most people can only hold their breath for a minute or two. They also have see-through or clear eyelids. When they go under the water and their eyelids close, they're kind of like goggles, which allows them to see underwater and not worry about mud and other things getting in their eyes. They also have valves that close in their nostrils and their ears, so no water gets in when they're under the water. And behind their teeth, in their mouth, they have a flap of skin that actually closes off when they're under the water, that allows them to hold things like sticks and mud in their mouth under the water without getting a bunch of water in their throat. So, as you can see, the beaver has amazing adaptations designed to allow them to live and thrive in and around the water. Very cool example of a watershed aquatic river.